So the answer turns out to be yes. First of all, if you take the dot product of these two vectors, what do you get? You get minus the sine of theta times the cosine of theta plus the cosine of theta times the sine of theta. So clearly that's equal to zero. Now take the dot product of this vector with itself. What do you get? You get sine theta squared plus cosine theta squared. And we know that that's equal to 1. So that means that that's a vector of length 1. Similarly, if we take this vector and take the dot product with itself, we get cosine squared theta plus sine squared theta. And we know that that's equal to 1 as well. So these vectors are mutually orthonormal. What about these vectors? Well, let's see. They look very similar. And if you go through exactly the same exercise, you will find that those are mutually orthonormal as well. Here's another homework. If we have k vectors that are mutually orthonormal, and we take those vectors and we make them into the columns of a matrix, we've done that many, many times before in this course, then the claim is, if you transpose that matrix and multiply it times itself, you get the identity. So go and do that homework.